Hello, thank you all for being present. I'm Priscilla Sterling, the family member of Emmett Till, and I represent the Emmett Till Justice for Families here in the state of Mississippi. I know everybody is wondering what's the outcome of the arrest warrant being found in LaFleur County. And as of today, we have Dwayne Richardson, who's a DA out of Greenville, that has not moved on the warrant. So we are here today to put pressure on Dwayne Richardson issuing the warrant. I know that over a period of time, 67 years, nothing has been done as far as this warrant. The family wants Carolyn Bryant to face justice. And by facing justice, we want her to at least come and defend herself, and not the state of Mississippi or the federal government. We feel that the federal government and the state is protecting Carolyn because they've told Dwayne Richardson not to move on the warrant. So what is really going on here in the state of Mississippi? So we have the local agencies here with us that's standing in support, and we're also having them to go down to Greenwood to the courthouse to demand that at least Dwayne Richardson sees what we see, the pain and suffering our family have felt for the last 67 years. The warrant must be issued. It must be executed. It must be executed. Why? What are they waiting on to execute a warrant? It was found. There's other information that warrants the Department of Justice to reopen this case, not just based on the arrest warrant being found. We have other information of a gentleman, Will Hill, that was also present at the store when Emmett came in and whistled at Carolyn Bryant. And he has never been interviewed by FBI, but he still is alive, still stays on the property, and he was friends with Simeon Wright, knew exactly where they stayed while he was working for Roy Bryant at the store. So this type of evidence alone must demand justice for Dwayne Richardson to serve this arrest warrant. And that's why we're here today. We're putting pressure on the DA out of Greenville, Mississippi, Dwayne Richardson, to execute this search warrant and to at least convene a new grand jury to present this evidence I've just mentioned. So please stand with us while those in solidarity stand with us as well. Thank you.
Yes, thank you, Priscilla. I'm Brother Kareem Muhammad with the Local Organizing Committee of Mississippi, Southwest Region and the Southern Region. We are here today in solidarity of the Emmett Till family to their continuing efforts toward seeking justice for our family, Emmett Till. We want to first be thankful and thank our mother, Emmett Till's mother, for allowing the ancestors to get into the spirit of her to guide her so that we would never lose that image of the terrorism and brutality that happened to our brother Emmett Till, but was going on in our family and to our families during that period of time. So we stand here in solidarity of the Emmett Till family. We stand here in solidarity of Sister Priscilla, who represents the Emmett Till family here in Mississippi, in her continuous efforts to make sure not only that justice is served, but with situations like what we see going on right now with the DOJ and others in the institutions such as the Mississippi State of Corrections and others, the criminal justice system, the Department of DA, refusing to issue that warrant. We stand in solidarity with her through her continued efforts in that area. And the local organizing committee stands as the or else aspect of all of this. The local organizing committee, who is a conglomerate of organizations, not no one organization, but sit at the table with the NAACP, the NOI, the New Black Panther Party, and other local organizations and national organizations, progressive organizations, religious institutions, entrepreneurs working collectively together to be a liaison and a voice for the people, for those that are voiceless, to work in collectively with those that work in government, to say to them is that you will be held accountable for your actions today, that you will understand that the masses of the people, if you do not do the justice that we know need to be done in behalf of the Emmett Till family and many of our families that has went through that tragedy, if you do not do that, then our job is to mobilize our pieces, our people. Mobilize our people to the point that we can now begin to take out those that are not serving our interests and put those that are serving our interests, desire to serve our interests, into play. So again, today, we don't talk in behalf of one individual, but we talk together as a nation, as a national movement that talk about justice or else. And we must come to understand what do the or else means. The RS is not the same as it happened in 1870s when they went into our political arenas, went into our political families and destroyed them and ran them out through gunpoint and terrorism. The RS is not that. The RS is that Mississippi, who is over 3 million population in this country, in this state, over 40% of the population is black. So we have the power with over 80, 90% of those individuals being in the Mississippi Delta. We have the economic and, the political power, number-wise, to change our conditions if we just understand the power that we have from the political perspective. So we are here today in solidarity, speaking on behalf of the Emmett Till family and saying that if you do not do justice by the people, then we have individuals that will be able to mobilize our people. We brought one individual like that all the way, traveling throughout this country, a strong, hard-hitting brother that represent masses of legal minds as well as grassroots organizing that's been working diligently throughout the country for those that have been unjustly treated. And I believe my brother is here, and I would like to turn this over at this time to our brother, Brother Malik Zulu Sabash.
All right. How you doing? Good afternoon. Good afternoon. I want to say to those who are with me, okay, my name is Malik Shabazz. I'm a national attorney, a national civil rights attorney. I head Black Lawyers for Justice, and I also represent the new Black Panther Party. I have just come from Raleigh, North Carolina, and I've come to Mississippi. I've come here about the critical and important matter of Emmett Till and his death and murder, which no one has been held accountable for. That's the main reason we're here, that after all these years, 67 years, that no one has been held accountable. And it is an actual fact that we have a fugitive on the loose, a fugitive from justice named Carolyn Bryant Dornum that has been literally on the escape or the loose for 67 years and has yet to stand trial for this horrific and gruesome murder of Emmett Till, who is the spark and the origin behind the momentum of the civil rights movement. Okay, and last week it was found that in LaFleur County that they mysteriously found a warrant for her arrest and for kidnapping. As we get ready to head there now to meet with the district attorney, Richardson, and to go to Greenwood, Mississippi, we're headed from here. But we're here right now in solidarity with the Emmett Till Foundation. With the you, Emmett Till, come on, man, please. Come on, bro. Please. All right, Priscilla. Pleasure. Hey, brother. Come on. Come on, King. It's all right. So I'm here. I'm honored to stand here to give national solidarity to the Emmett Till Foundation and the Emmett Till family, because they have suffered for years, and they have suffered the indignity of the murderers of Emmett Till admitting to the crime in magazines, gallivanting around America with no justice being done. and Carolyn Bryant Dornan must be brought to justice.
That's right.
We want Mississippi to know and the nation to know that Carolyn Bryant Dornan must be brought to justice. She must stand trial for lying on Emmett Till and working with the kidnappers in conspiracy for his murder. And some of you may say, oh, well, what difference does it make? She's 87 years old. She's 87 years old. Why don't we just let her rest in peace? Well, Emmett Till never got to make it to 87.
Come on.
Emmett Till never had another day where he could go to a nursing home or whatever, because his life was taken at the precious age of 14 years old. And now we are here in Mississippi to say that justice will not rest, justice will not sleep. What do we want?
Justice.
And when do we want it?
Now.
What must we have?
Justice.
And when must we have it?
Now.
And how do we intend to get it?
Mobilize.
Fresh.
See, I say, when I ask that question,
yes,
I answer it. I say, by any means necessary. It's how we intend to get justice. We will not let this rest. Now, I was in Raleigh, North Carolina, where the last known addresses of Carolyn Bryant Dornan was yesterday. We searched for her all through Raleigh, North Carolina. We went to the front doors of her doors and her doorstep, and they are hiding her. She is being hit. She may even be hidden in this state right now. But I'm here to tell you that Malik Shabazz, I know the Emmett Till family from everything we're reading, Brother Kareem Muhammad, the Nation of Islam, and the new Black Panther Party, and good people of Mississippi, and people of goodwill,
yes,
people
sir.
Of justice and common sense all over this country are not going to let this case rest, are not going to let this case rest. And so that's why we're here, and that's why we're headed to Greenwood. And that's why there's a national campaign right now to rein Ms. Dornan in. We will not allow her to, with an outstanding warrant, to walk around America free. The Justice Department must do something. The Mississippi justice system must do something. And we are definitely going to do something. If we have to convene a people's grand jury here in Mississippi and indict her ourselves, and take action ourselves, then that's what's going to have to be taken. And that's what we're going to talk with the activist in Greenwood about. Carolyn Bryant Dornan must be brought to justice.
And she must face justice.
She must face justice.
She must
face.
She must be there to defend herself and not the state of Mississippi or the federal government.
All right. That is our statement, that is our mission, and this is just the beginning. There is just the beginning. We absolutely intend to find her. We absolutely intend to know that she is not welcome in any neighborhood, in any state, in the United States of America, that there is no hiding place from justice. There's no running place from justice. There's nowhere that she will live in peace, so she might as well stand trial, because there's a new Black man and woman on the scene here in Mississippi that's not going to lay down and tolerate it. And they have friends from all over the country,
yes,
and
sir.
Friends in high places and many places. Black power?
Black power.
Black power.
Black power.
Black power.
Black power.
Okay, what do we want?
Justice.
And when must we have it?
Now.
What do we want?
Justice.
And when must we have it?
Now.
We head to Greenwood, Mississippi, right now to see the district attorney right now. That's where we're headed, and thank you for your time.